What's up, y'all? It's the Machinon. It's time for another one. So, all hell Doomcock. So we're gonna talk a little bit about Doomcock's rumors that he gets, because he has those little insiders that gives him some tips that's going on in the Lucasfilm Disney regime team over there. And I just want to discuss some of the things that was brought up with his rumors that he got. And of course, like he says on his own videos, take this with a grain of salt, because you can't confirm or deny any of these things. So with that being said, let's take a look at them. So there's actually three things that was brought to his attention, and I wanted to discuss them myself. So the first one would be, this is a way to fix what's been going on in the Disney Star Wars regime, because they actually noticed us, the fandom, and it shouldn't be a surprise, because we've had Dave Rubin mention it. We have J.J. Abrams mention it. So the fandom menace has been heard of within the bigger mainstream scope of things. So with that being said, the first option to fix the crap show that's the Disney Star Wars trilogy is the long goodbyes, is revising rather than deleting. And with this would be basically just tweaking the things that's going on with the movie, altering certain things, you know, I don't know. So that, whatever. And the second one would be erasing the sequel trilogy altogether, right? And then the third idea would be to just do George Lucas's version of the sequel trilogy and ignore all of that. And the first one, which would be them going back and using the veil of the Force and going back and saying, you know, telling Luke not to kill Ben or attempt to kill Ben. It's still dumb, and I agree with him on that too, because it still puts Luke Skywalker as a person who wanted to redeem his father, you know, the genocidal maniac Anakin / Vader, and wanted to redeem his father, but because his nephew had bad thoughts, he was going to eliminate his nephew. Still a bad move. The other one, which is erasing the sequel trilogy, honestly, to tell you the truth, all three of these, in my opinion, everything here, I say, just, you know what, to be fair, look, and I've said this before, to be fair to Doomcock and all the people out there who goes out there and give him these rumors and all this stuff like this, just leave it alone. You know what, you made the mistake. Own up to your mistake and just move on. Because if you go back to this, you're just going to be digging up those old wounds. That's what you're going to be doing. That's all you're going to be doing, just basically putting salt on those old wounds, opening them up and putting salt on them. Nobody, look, at this point, because there's nothing you can do to fix not having Luke, Leia, and Han together. You can't fix that. It's impossible to fix it now. There's no way to do it. So, me personally, I would say, screw all of this. And by the way, with the putting George in charge, he actually said that Lucas wanted to have full control until otherwise, right? Now, again, this is all rumors, right? Kennedy has to be out, which, that's without saying her contract's up next year. So, if at worst case scenario, she's going to ride it out to December 31st, 2021. Maybe. The best case scenario, she'd be like, I'm out in June next year, whatever, who cares? But honestly, whatever. The sequel trilogy must be remade. This is under George. And then also the fourth stipulation was never touch the original trilogy as it stayed the way it was, which I'm assuming is they don't want to put new actors in. And that's the whole point I'm trying to get at. If you take what he's saying here, just leave it alone. If you want George to come back, great. George, here's what I want you to do. You screwed up, right? You screwed up. You sold it to these idiots. I don't care how nice. Look, bro, I'm going to be straight up with you. I'm gonna be straight up with you, right? And knock on wood, any of this stuff actually works out for me, and I actually, you know, something becomes of this little journey that I'm doing right now. Please believe, I ain't selling no corporation nothing. Nothing. I stays the boss, okay? That's what happens. I will stay the boss. That's what you should have did, George, is stay the boss. Like, okay, Bob, hey, here's what I'll let you do. I'll let you license a couple of things for me, but you're not getting it. That's what I would have done. You know, and again, I don't want to hear this, oh, it was because of the prequels. Everybody, listen, nobody was getting at George about the prequels other than, really, the media. Because, remember, the internet wasn't a big thing back then. It really wasn't. It was starting to cook, but it was nothing like how it is now. So for you try to say, oh, it was the fans that kind of got at George and made him be like this, you know, got disenfranchised and doing the whole, running the Lucasfilm and all that. Listen, if anything, same thing with Ahmaud Best, right? I didn't like Jar Jar. I didn't think it was the best character, but I didn't care about the actor and actresses out there. Same thing with Kelly Marie Tran. I didn't like the character roles. I thought it was a bad character, but I got nothing but love for Kelly Marie Tran. It's nothing that had nothing to do with her. That's what the idiots did who wrote that story. That had nothing to do with the actual characters. And again, if you wanted to say that, you know, him being feeling some kind of way about the prequel trilogy was one of the factors that made him want to sell it, I'm not buying that. If anything, it was the media who put that dark cloud over him, you know, and whatever. So here's the thing: if you wanna bring George back, you wanna fix what you got wrong. Here's what I'm gonna tell you: what you do, you made this bed, leave it. George, you wanna get back in charge, run the show. What I would do if I was you: go to the drawing board, take a nap on it, sleep on it. You know, take the idea you had from your sequel trilogy, tweak it. If anything, I mean, you couldn't even do that. If at the worst case scenario, I would take some things from the EU and just move. Honestly, here's what I would do. Again, this is something that we've talked about before. If you wanted to really call yourself fixing it, okay, recanonize the EU, and start from Alana Solo. That's the only thing I can tell you to do. Because then you could cast new characters, right? That wouldn't have to necessarily affect the old characters. And you could still have Luke in there. He would be the only one alive. So you'd have to tweak it. You'd have to say that Luke is the only one alive out of the trio still. Honestly, what I would do is I would tweak the Mara Jade story, have her still be alive, right? You know, this is the only way you're going to be able to fix this, to me. If you wanted to take over, this going back and changing things, nah, don't even do it, because you're just gonna piss people off. Because for one, I'm not going to buy it. You know, I don't want to know anything about this sequel trilogy from now. You got to change, you got to go move away from it. That's how I feel about it. But I've been ranting and raving anyway. By the way, George, again, if I had my DeLorean, the only time I would use the Veil of the Force, or not even the DeLorean, Veil of the Force, I'm mixing up franchises. But if I had some way to time travel, the one thing to fix this is going back and telling you not to sell your baby. That's the only way you need to really use the Veil of the Force. But anyway, how do you feel about Doomcock's rumors? Do you think this is something that should be done? Are you with me? Should they just ignore all of the sequel trilogy stuff and move forward? How would you do it? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit the notification bell so you get my miss on the job. Remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Peace. I heard that the best bet is Monopoly.